Chair of Governors, Governors, ladies and gentlemen and young Felstedians, welcome to Felsted Prep School's first ever virtual speech day. This has been quite an extraordinary year in so many respects. Whilst I don't want to dwell too much upon the unprecedented challenges of recent months, I do want to share with you my admiration for the courage and resilience that all members of the community have demonstrated of late, pupils, staff and parents. As we now begin to emerge from the other side of this crisis, we do so sure in the knowledge that those bonds which have been forged in adversity have only served to enrich and intensify our relationships with one another. We've inspired each other to live with hope and face the future in the sure knowledge that we will emerge from this in a stronger position than ever before. We have not simply survived, we have grown together and thrived together during these most testing of times. I'm incredibly grateful to everyone for their hard work, energy and much valued support of our remote learning programme. Your kind words about our provision have been most appreciated. Over the past few weeks, I've started watching a wonderful documentary series called The Last Dance, which chronicles the final year of Michael Jordan's illustrious career as an NBA player with the Chicago Bulls. What has this got to do with the pupils? Actually, a huge number of the characteristics, such as overcoming adversity and the sheer will to succeed and improve, is something to which all of our pupils should aspire. Michael Jordan is arguably the greatest sportsman of all time, and certainly the greatest to be part of a team sport. Like the best learners, he'd learned from his mistakes and rarely repeated them on the basketball court. He accepted that certain players would have their day, but learned from their skills and prowess and vowed to get better after defeats. This growth mindset resulted in his exponential improvement when other players plateaued ahead of their time. Today, Speech Day is all about people, and so, in fact, is education and life more widely, something that I feel the last 3 months has certainly highlighted. But as pupils or parents, I want my focus today to be centred around what extraordinary people, like Michael Jordan, for example, say each day. To say something every day to change someone's day for the better. There are some habits you can get into, things which you can try to say every day. The first one is, here's what I'm thinking. This says you're in control, but it doesn't mean you're smarter or savvier or more insightful than everyone else. Through taking the time to explain your decisions opens up those decisions to discussion, but it also opens up your discussions to improvement. Secondly, the phrase, I was wrong. Hopefully, not one you'll use every day. When you're wrong, though, say you're wrong. You won't lose respect, you'll actually gain it. Thirdly, that was fantastic. No one gets enough praise, no one. Pick anyone who does or did something well and tell them what a great job they did. Make sure your praise is specific so they know what you liked and so will do it again. You can use cards, post-it notes, small gifts. All of these work. The next one is, you're welcome. Think about a time when you gave a gift and the recipient seemed uncomfortable or awkward. Their reaction took a little of the fun away for you, maybe? And the same can happen when you are thanked or complimented or praised. Don't spoil the moment for the other person. Just look them in the eye and say thank you or you're welcome. Can you help me? When you need help, regardless of the type of help you need or the person you need it from, just say sincerely and humbly, can you help me? I promise you'll get help. And in the process, you'll show that vulnerability, respect, and a willingness to listen. I'm sorry. We all make mistakes, so we all have things we need to apologise for. Say you're sorry, say why you're sorry, and take the blame. Then you can both get the time to make the freshest of starts. The next one is, let me give you a hand. Many people see asking for help as a weakness, and so hesitate to ask. Be specific, find something you can help with. Say, I've got a few minutes, can I help you finish with that? And finally, nothing. Sometimes the best thing to say is nothing. If you're upset, frustrated, or angry, stay quiet. Sometimes saying nothing is the best thing. It's a great lesson. Now, what about that 2019-2020 episode of the Felsted Prep School story and the difference we as a school have made? The desire to learn is at the heart of the education we seek to provide. And the idea is that we develop passions and interests at Felsted that can be developed over a lifetime. The list of academic highlights and opportunities is, I believe, an excellent indicator that we are encouraging our pupils to think more independently and to be curious about the world they're living in. As a prep school, we've been working very hard to develop further opportunities for pupils to achieve academic enrichment beyond the classroom. STEM continues to be a strong focus in the prep school, combining science, technology, engineering and maths through relevant and engaging topic areas. We were delighted to have two teams recognised as winners of the Sustainability Prize and the Best STEM Communicators Prize at the Regional Science and Engineering Competition. From this event, Anna, Freya, Grace and Ava were selected to represent the East of England at the 2020 National Science and Engineering Finals, which were due to be held in March, but unfortunately cancelled due to COVID-19. A chemistry project saw the pupils run cosmetic events for their parents, as well as entering the 2020 Scrub Up for Science competition, all helping pupils understand how STEM links to everyday life. Despite this, we have widened our engagement to these activities to ensure all pupils have the opportunity to take part in these extended projects. All pupils in Year 7 are currently working towards their Bronze BA Crest Awards, and some projects will be entered into the big regional Bang Science and Engineering competition as soon as the event is up and running. 60 pupils from Year 6 have completed their Young Engineers projects and have entered the Young Engineers National Competition, having been inspired by visiting engineers to design their own inventions. We look forward to hearing the final outcome on this as the judging process is now happening later in the year. All Year 5 pupils are currently working towards their Star Crest Award for Creativity in Engineering, Science and Technology, and we hope they can complete the final activities over the holidays to achieve their certificates. All pupils in Year 5 through to 9 were entered for the Bebras UK Computing Competition, and an incredible 39 pupils made the top 5% nationally, and we were selected to take part in the second round, which unfortunately couldn't take place. We've also taken part in the second GCHQ Cyber First Girls Challenge, and this involved 6 teams of 4 Year 7 girls focusing on building coding skills through collaboration and teamwork to break cybersecurity networks. One team qualified for the regional finals, where they did fantastically well. Literacy skills are also a key focus. We've increased opportunities to develop debating skills by taking part in the Model United Nations from Years 5 to 8. Sadly, the Foreign Language Spelling Bee and Translation Bee were cancelled due to COVID. However, Lewis won a prize in the Senior SATIPS General Knowledge Challenge this year, and a number of our Year 5 pupils entered the BBC Radio 2 500-word story writing competition, and one pupil, Alina, was shortlisted as a finalist from nationwide entries of over 134,000 children. And the curriculum enrichment, which allows all the pupils to grow, continues to be enjoyed by everybody. In design technology, 6 pupils in Year 8, Sachiko, Tawana, Gus, Harley, Jack and Oliver, entered the Land Rover 4x4 in Schools Challenge. For the competition, they were tasked with modifying a remote-controlled rock crawler to enter the challenge to compete against other schools nationally. They printed their 3D body for their rock crawler and coded it with a Raspberry Pi to control a series of sensors, giving the car automatic lights and a tilt warning system. They took their car to Harlow College to compete against other schools within the London and South East region and were awarded the Silver Award in the development class they entered. They also won awards for the Best Showroom due to their impressive display and Best Engineered Car Award due to the overall build quality. This meant they were invited to the national finals, a huge achievement in itself. Creativity, imagination and skills have blossomed over the last year with pupils, feeling inspired to produce work on a huge range of themes, experimenting with materials, exploring and developing their own artistic language. The virtual learning environment has certainly not hampered pupils' artistic journeys. In fact, quite the opposite. Ideas were nurtured and grown, and artistic spirit has flourished, often with just a pencil and a found piece of paper. Perhaps a moment away from the screen prompted that creative flow. A whole school project on the theme of isolation and lockdown inspired pupils to create artwork inside a box while having to think outside of it. The question of what is most important to me inspired drawings, paintings, and photography based on family, friends, Felsted, communication, pets, nature, and of course the NHS, the overriding message rang out loud and clear that spending time with people we love and care about is the most important thing of all. World Book Day was also an opportunity for everyone to dress up as their favourite villain, which provided some wonderful outfits. And this year has also been a very busy one in Stuart House. Our youngest Felstedians have learned through creative topics with opportunities to problem solve, and I've been so impressed with their engagement with their remote learning programme. The Accelerated Reader programme continues to thrive, and as a school, we have over 81 word millionaires this year. And as a school, we have read a staggering 230 million words. It's also been a fabulous year for music at the prep school, and that has continued during virtual school with so many brilliant online concerts and performances. Virtual music lessons have worked very well, and the pupils have found that singing, dancing, and playing an instrument during their time at home has been a very rewarding experience. League music brought us all together for a day full of atmosphere and excitement. So much team spirit on show and so much talent in the room. Christmas concerts and carol services showed off the hard work of our orchestras, steel bands, ensembles and choirs. And many pupils achieved excellent team results in music, including lots of studying music theory. Swing into Spring is the biggest event in the Felsted calendar, combining 200 performers from across the school. Yet again, the skill and enthusiasm of our pupils was a real joy to behold on this special evening. Drama was bereft of performances this year, with both Singing in the Rain and The Jungle Book unfortunately cancelled. However, we were treated earlier in the year to the fabulous Year 3-4 production of The Snow Queen. Charity and service are also key elements of what we want to develop in our young pupils. Martin Luther King once said, "Life's most persistent question is, what are you doing for others?" Our charity work began with our Harvest Festival back in September, followed by our Fund for Funds fete led by our Year 8 pupils. Pupils donated toiletries for our school charity, UK Aid, which took nearly a van full of our donations to the Ukraine in October. And the Fund for Funds rate raised over £1,600, which was shared equally with our five league charities, Farley Hospice, David Randall Foundation, Chess Homeless, the Trussell Trust Food Bank, and Helen and Douglas Hospice. The autumn term also saw us as a prep school raising money for Children in Need, Save the Children, the Poppy Appeal, Sparkle Malawi, Little Havens Hospice, and our sponsored children. Year 4 visited the almshouses with harvest baskets, and the Froome Court Chamber Choir sang at Abbey Fields in Felsted, and Courtauld House pupils and Stuart House supported the local food bank. In January, we supported the Australian Bushfires Appeal, and Stuart House held a cake sale for the David Rounder Foundation. And our annual charity day in March allowed pupils in years 5 to 8 to run their own stall for a chosen charity. Over 11 charities were supported and a total of £1,200 was raised. During lockdown, service by the pupils has continued, and Froome Court pupils sent Easter cards to the elderly residents of Felsted. And some of our pupils helped with the donation of cards and Easter eggs to the local hospitals. And more recently, pupils have supported the Safi Coffee Initiative, donating packages to hospitals and care homes. Courtauld House pupils have also helped donate supplies to the NHS. Some of our musical pupils have also supported the Clap for Carers every week, playing their instruments at their homes with great gusto. Sport continues to thrive in every discipline across the school. Our philosophy remains sport for all, where engagement and enjoyment are the key. And we have again had a record number of teams represent the school across all sports, with participation, as I say, being the key. In netball, our under 13 and under 12 teams qualify for the IAPS national finals, which were unfortunately cancelled. But rugby has also had a good year across all the age groups, with skill sets developing well. Congratulations must go to the under 11 A team, who came first at the IAPS tournament, winning all of their matches, and the undefeated under 12 A and under 13 and under 12 touch teams. Hockey for the boys and girls to continue to develop with numerous fixtures at all age groups, with highlights being our under 13 girls being crowned into Hockey Essex champions and again IAPS national finalists. The boys also made the IAPS national finals, achieving a magnificent fourth place, losing the semi-final on strokes to the eventual winners. And they were also into Hockey national finalists before this was also sadly cancelled. Despite the lack of any outdoor cricket this summer, our girls under 13 team were crowned indoor Essex champions back in February. Squash continued to go from strength to strength as children from years 3 to 8 were provided the opportunity to play in activities, holiday sessions and PE and one-to-one coaching. Prep school pupils have played in internal matches, friendlies versus other clubs and schools. In the English National Schools competition, our young under 14 team, consisting mainly of prep school pupils, finished runners-up in the county, qualifying to progress to the regional of the cup competition, where they finished 4th. This year, the riding squad have continued to perform at a very high level, competing at National Schools Equestrian Association team and individual events, alongside team members from the senior school. Martha has consistently performed exceptionally well, being part of the team, winning the 1 metre arena eventing and second place individually in the 90 centimetre arena eventing national plate competition. And she also qualified alongside fellow team member Ollie for the national plate 90 centimetre show jumping competition in November. However, at all times, our children and staff represent the school with great distinction and unbounded enthusiasm. The sight of a very busy playing field or AstroTurf on a Wednesday or Saturday afternoon is a true highlight for me because it illustrates our aim to provide opportunities for all our pupils to represent the school at their level. This was never more on show than at last week's fantastic virtual sports week, where individual endeavour matched league spirit and loyalty. At this point, I'd like to say a few thank yous. Thank you to the pupils for being the wonderful school that you are. Thank you to the staff for your unwavering enthusiasm and dedication to your work during the most testing of times. You have been truly magnificent. And thank you to you, our parents, for supporting your children and us in all that we do. And finally, thank you to the governors for all the tireless work you do in supporting the school in so many ways. And now to a few goodbyes. Firstly, thank you to our wonderful sports GRA, Jess, and our wonderful Cloisters TA, Miss Pitt, who both leave us to take up teacher training courses. We wish them all the very best. We also say farewell to Mrs. Wilding after 2 great years with us teaching maths across the prep school, as well as being a much-loved form tutor in Cloisters. We also say goodbye to Mrs. Phillips after 3 years of teaching in Stuart House. Her gentle nature and creative teaching will be sorely missed. Jennifer Gilling also moves on after 9 years as an inspirational head of modern foreign languages. She developed internationalism within the school, as well as supporting our mindfulness programme. Hilary Hancock moved just a few metres down the road from FKS to join the prep school staff in September 1998 and retires this term after an amazing 22 years here. Hilary, or should we say Mrs. Hancock, has been an inspiration to young Felstedians with her dedication and commitment to her classroom teaching of mathematics and also outside on the sports fields. Mrs. Hancock has taught right across the age ranges of years 3 to 8, being especially adept at finding ways for her pupils to develop strong mathematical skills as the foundation for their future learning. You only had to listen to outside her classroom door to witness her passion for teaching. I ate and I was sick on the floor, would chant her class as they learnt that 8 times 8 equaled 64. She was particularly keen on helping those pupils who found the learning of mathematical concepts to be quite challenging. Many break times were spent running extra math sessions with individuals and small groups of pupils, helping them become more confident in this core subject. In recent years, having gone part-time, Mrs. Hancock has focused on helping those individuals who needed one-to-one support. But she has been adamant that she still wanted to keep her maths year 8 set. Her last group will be sharing their last speech day with Hilary today. A generation of Felstedians will join us in thanking Hilary for sowing the mathematical seeds that have set them up for life. Mrs. Hancock's other passion has been the traditional girls' sports here at Felsted, where she has coached hockey, netball, rounders, cricket and tennis. In these sports, her teams have achieved incredible success, especially as coach to the under 13 girls' hockey seven, who for a number of years were Essex champions. Hilary, Felsted Prep School pupils, colleagues and parents, both past and present, would like to thank you for your unstinting dedication, drive and passion for all that you have achieved here at Felsted over the past 22 years. We join together to wish you all the very best for a fully deserved retirement. Jill Brown, arrived at Felsted Prep School in 1992 to teach French throughout the school. Jill was instrumental in bringing a more relevant approach to the teaching of foreign languages, moving away from the traditional recitation of verbs and the completion of grammar exercises, to teaching and learning via linking together reading, writing, speaking and listening skills. By the time the decision was made for Spanish to become the main foreign language at Felsted, Jill was fluent and ready to embrace the change. Now known as Señorita Brown, she has developed the teaching of Spanish as it was rolled out across the prep school, starting with the youngest reception pupils. Indeed, even now, those youngest Felstedians benefit from Jill's teaching, with their first taste of Spanish being the singing and chanting of numbers, colours and days of the week in Stuart House. Jill's other passion was for horse riding, and through her links with Berry Farm and Rain Riding School, horse riding was introduced on the prep school curricular activities list for both beginners and more experienced riders. It wasn't long before Jill founded the FPS equestrian team, where local and national successes were achieved by a multitude of Felsted pupils. As time went by, she started to practice and embrace the benefits of mindfulness, and we are all so grateful to Jill for her time and effort when helping staff, pupils and parents with mindfulness sessions over the past 10 years. Charitable causes and helping those less fortunate than ourselves have always been close to Jill's heart, and in particular, she's been a volunteer ambassador for the Sparkle Foundation in Malawi. Jill, although you're retiring from teaching, we know you will continue to support Sarah and this wonderful cause in the years ahead. Finally, a huge thank you for all your time and effort that you have given to Felsted over the past 28 years. You are a true professional with a heart of gold. All of us, as teaching colleagues, pupils and parents, past and present, offer our best wishes to you for a thoroughly deserved retirement. At this point, I hope you'll indulge me if I am to focus on our Year 8 leavers just for a moment. I thought at this juncture it was appropriate for me to offer you some advice, which I hope you will heed, and it centres around the theme of happier living. Connect with people, keep learning, take a positive approach, be part of something bigger. As Dr. Seuss said, you're off to great places. Today is your day, your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Each leaving year group hands on the torch to the one that follows it. Your year group will have a unique place in Felsted Prep School's history. You've lived through an unprecedented term, the year that they weren't at school for their summer term. But we will not remember you as the year that did not. We will remember you as the year that did. You did manage the most exceptional of times. You did stay together, and you did yourself and the school proud. As each of you prepares to leave the prep school, we are all proud of you. You are the year group that did, and you will go on to be the people who do. Once again, thank you for all you have given to the prep school. For the rest of us, the consequences of lockdown have been sobering, yet many of us have also experienced some unforeseen form of silver lining. From spending more time with friends and family, or to getting more exercise, we have realised that this situation presents not just challenges, but opportunities. The same may be true for the big return. Whilst it will no doubt throw us many more challenges, it will also be wonderful to be back to the prep school we all know and love so well. Thank you for listening. It's now my honour to announce our Year 8 prizes for this year. The 8AH Form Prize goes to Isabella Wellsford Knightley, and the 8AH Progress Prize to Sissy Swale. The 8FH Form Prize to Isabel Campbell, and the 8FH Progress Prize to Elphine Atkins. The 8HM Forward Prize to Florence Bonser, and the 8HM Progress Prize to Austin Kershaw. The 8PB Form Prize to Freya Perry, and the 8PB Progress Prize to Charlie Mendham. The 8RD Form Prize goes to Anna Barrow, and the 8RD Progress Prize to Harry Pigram. The Year 8 Felstedian Prizes are awarded to Isla Ahmed, Hugo Dewar, Oscar Harvey, Ava Redman, Alexander Smith, Lewis Turner, Florence van Vilstren, and Anna White. The English Prize goes to Jasmine Wincott, The Searle Cup for the Young Mathematician of the Year goes to Tegan Clark, and the Science Prize to Millie Asprey. The Spanish Prize is awarded to Martha Miller, the French Prize to Hannah Page, the German Prize to Phoebe Holmes, and the Latin Prize to Isabella Welsford Knightley. The Nichols Cup for Outstanding Geographer in Year 8 goes to Arva Stapleton. The History Prize is awarded to Freya Perry. The Religious Studies Prize to Olivia Wiltshire. The Art Prize to Melek Sahin. And the Spooner Trophy for Design, Technology and Engineering to Tawana Tuma. The Drama Prize goes to Georgia Broadbent. The Music Prize is awarded to Owen Page. The PE Prize is shared between Neve Sheehan and Maxime Guarino. And the Computing Prize is awarded to Grace Burrows. The Orchestra Prize is awarded to Hannah Page, and the Choir Prize goes to Olivia Reese. The Courtauld House Macaulay Cup for Outstanding Achievement in Learning Support is awarded to Eleanor Tinsley. The Harvey Award for Excellence in STEM and the Smart Cup for the Courtauld House Young Musician of the Year are awarded to Thomas Rusko. The Tortie Lee Drama Cup goes to Amelie Lamont. The David Randall Foundation Inspirational Award goes to Lois Pavitt. The Stewart Cup for the greatest contribution to all-round girls' sport is shared between Sachiko Smart and Julia Zangermeister. And the Stewart Cup for the greatest contribution to boys' all-round sport is shared between Theo McElvenner and Gus Peddy. The Olympic Cup is awarded to Millie Asprey and Olivia Rees. The Burrett Cup for Outstanding Academic Achievement is this year awarded to Julia Zangermeister. And the Heads Prize for this year goes to Tegan Clark.
Lockdown leavers unite. Let's stand together. The end is in sight.
Lockdown leavers rejoice. The year of all years, we sing with one voice.
We've been socially distanced on Google and Zoom. We've been welcomed with smileys to our virtual classroom.
We've quizzed and competed on premium Kahoot. We've played virtual concerts on piano and flute.
Artworks, experiments, models galore, creative endeavours, new worlds to explore.
We've jumped and we've jogged to get ourselves fitter. The best of our work has been featured on Twitter.
Our teachers have toiled to deliver online. They toasted each victory with a small glass of wine.
We've cooked, whipped and baked. We've stitched and sewn masks. Attempted a host of co-curricular tasks.
We've missed friends and family and socials at school. No hugs for our grandparents, that 2 metre rule.
We've applauded and praised the key workers and carers, the doctors and nurses, the PPE wearers.
And just when our patience and energy is low, we've looked to the sky for that painted rainbow.
Lockdown leavers rejoice. Resolve and compassion, our weapons of choice.
Lockdown leavers unite. Let's stand together. The end is in sight.
Welcome to Wonderland, I'll be your guide. Holding your hand under sapphire skies. Let's go exploring, or we can just go for a walk. Welcome to Wonderland, where should we go? There's a tea party along down the road. Make an appearance and maybe I'll sing us a song. Dancing through a dream underneath the stars. Laughing till the morning comes. Everyone that leaves has a heavy heart. Oh, Wonderland, I love. And the only thing sure from the start is a song that's inside of your heart. Don't let it leave. If this was a dream, then at least I've got memories for when morning comes. Now that I must leave with a heavy heart, oh, wonderland I love.
That concludes today's speech day. Thank you for taking the time to listen. I wish you all a wonderful Saturday and a fantastic summer holiday. And we look forward to seeing you all again in September. Take care.